Hey guys, Corey here. I am in North Austin getting ready to do a small home. It's got three rooms upstairs, one room downstairs, and stairs. So this room downstairs is the cleanest there is. Upstairs is pretty fancy. There's a lot of stuff going on. For this cleaning, I'm going to be using a mixture of simple green and hydrogen peroxide, and a lot of both. So, you know, the dirtier it is, the more you have to increase your cleaning agent, and you have to use more of it so you can move the soil. So I'm going to turn the camera around and we're going to take a look. We're not going upstairs. He's vacuuming upstairs right now. He's grinding up all kind of, I don't know what, on the carpet. So we turn around and take a look at this, and then I'm going to show this one when it's complete. Then we're going to go upstairs and do it room by room since I'm doing it on the phone. So hang on. All right. This is the downstairs master bedroom here. It's fairly soiled. It's heavily, heavily, heavily worn. So we're going to clean it up and make it look clean and worn. So that is going to look completely different. And they're probably not expecting it to turn out the way it's going to turn out. I always like to see that when people go, damn, I had no idea to expect it to look that good. All right, I'm going to spray this one and clean this one. Then we're going to have a look at it when I'm done. And we'll do the same upstairs. So I'll check back in a minute. Turned out pretty good. We're gonna go upstairs and take a look at three rooms up there and see if we can do the same thing up there. Meet you upstairs. All right, now we're upstairs. There's two bedrooms and a loft up here. So now there's stuff up here that's not gonna come out. The red's not. I have no idea what any of that is. And there's something in the other room that, who knows what it is. The carpet is actually hard. It's, it doesn't even feel like fabric anymore. This one here is just garden variety soil, nothing fancy here. Here's the stairs. We'll take a look at those before I do them. All this in here. And this room here is extra special. There's all kinds of stuff going on in here. Heavy, heavy, heavy soil here. Really ground in. And right over here, I don't know what this is, but the carpet is hard. It's weird. Here it's soft like carpet's supposed to be. In here it's just, it's hard as a rock. Weird. If I can, yeah, that's a good way to show it. So that's gonna be neat. I think I'm gonna do this one first since it looks like the most difficult thing I've done in a while. All right, I'm gonna start here. I'm gonna probably use the majority of my pre-spray on this room. I have to mix some more. All right, so I'm going to pre-spray this and show it completely done so you can see just before and after. The cleaning is going to take a while. All right, be back. All right, this is not perfect. It looks a whole lot better, but and there's no doubt you're going to be happy to see it looking like this, but there's a limit to what you can do to carpet. This area took, I didn't time how long this took. This took a while, but I managed to lift all that out of there and make it fluffy again. Some of the stuff are actual stains. The carpet stained a new color. Spent quite a bit of time going around getting chewing gum out of this. Shave it off the top with a razor blade, because by the time you get it dissolved out of there, you've dissolved the backing of the carpet. So it's a mechanical fix, and you got a whole lot of chewing gum. All right, we're gonna go look at the other two rooms, and I'm gonna have to reload the sprayer because I use a whole lot in here. So there's all through here, and this will be easier to clean. Everything will be easier to clean than that one. Let's see here again. All right, and this one here. So I'm gonna go reload the sprayer and continue to change the world one carpet at a time. Be right back. All right, moving right along here. Did this room. Now we're gonna do this one. See the difference between clean and not? Notice how much brighter it gets when you clean it, especially with the peroxide. All right, let's take a look at the rest of it. That's a burn mark over here is what this is. Yeah, someone dropped an iron. All right, let's take one more look here at this room. Getting ready to clean this one. These rooms are probably running 20 minutes a piece cleaning, at least. But this is the last one, then there's the stairs. So, stairs are no picnic. Alright, I'm going to do this one now, and we'll show this one when I'm done. Alright, now we're going to go in here. See what I just did. Oh, man. Turn the fan on. That didn't budge, and I never really thought it would. But there's some paint over there that's saturated into the carbon. I wouldn't recommend patching this stuff. It'd probably fall apart. All right, really all there is left is the stairs, but let's take a look over these three rooms that I just did up here. Feel free to back up the video and look at the before. We're going to take a look at the stairs and then clean those, and then we'll finish up the video. Man, these stairs are short, man. You can fall down. Your feet hang over the stairs when you're going down. Alright, stairs are kind of dark here. It's hard to see them. Look at them from the other direction. There we go. Light and bright in there. Alright, guys, I appreciate you watching this video. This one took way longer than it should have, but it turned out well. That's really all that matters, and it's just it probably makes for a good video. If anybody's, you know, wanting to know about this particular method of carpet cleaning, I'm gonna probably label it OP carpet cleaning or orbital pad carpet cleaning or organic carpet cleaning or something like that. Anyway, appreciate you watching the video. Please subscribe, like and share the video, and if you have questions, you're always welcome to text 512-350-1129.